If you're planning to take the CKA or the CKAD exam, this video may just save your score. Here are 10 mistakes that could tank otherwise perfectly acceptable performance and cause you to fail either of these very difficult exams. Number 1, forgetting to set the context. Every single task on either exam is going to have a section that says, run this command, kube control config set context, da-da-da. While context is not something that is explicitly mentioned in either objectives for either exam, it is something that can make or break your grade. Context is what sets where your kube control commands are executed. On the exam, for either, you will have multiple clusters that you are supposed to be working with, and there will be multiple namespaces on these clusters. Context is what sets the default. To what cluster are you writing to what namespace are you writing to, even as what user are you executing these commands as. So even if you make a perfectly good pod or whatever the task is asking for, you won't get credit because you put it in the wrong place. Not copying and pasting. Don't trust your typing abilities. The exam is very high pressure. All it takes is for you to be just one character off. And even though that pod or deployment or whatever may be created correctly, if it's not the name that the exam is looking for, you won't get credit. So there are copy buttons on the exam for you to click. Take advantage of those and make sure that you know how to paste inside of these exam environments as well. Not knowing basic Linux shell tools. Look, I know this is a Kubernetes exam, but you are running it inside of a Linux environment. And there will be some tasks that straight up will require Linux skills in order for you to complete. For instance, here's an example. Suppose that you are supposed to check the logs of a given pod. And from those lines, you are supposed to extract just what has a specific string. And then you're supposed to write that output to another file. Both of these are things that you would need Linux shell commands to do. So in this case, you would have to know how to use grep. I would like to filter out everything except what matches this expression, and then redirect, which is I would now like to take that output and I would like to put it inside of this file, inside of this path right here, please. Not understanding what the task is actually asking. You have to cultivate a mindset that these people, the CNCF, they want you to fail. And as a result, there will be some intentionally vague tasks. For instance, you may be told, make sure that this pod is being checked X number of seconds to make sure that it's functional, and if not, force it to restart. That is an example of a liveness probe. Hey, I scratch your back, you scratch mine. If these tips are helping you, please give this video a like and please subscribe to the channel. It really helps out. Struggling with text editors. Honestly, this is just as important as being skilled at Kubernetes before you take the exam, because you're going to have to edit a lot of files and it's all going to be done at the Linux command line. And you can use either Vim or Nano. Either one is fine, but make sure whichever one you are coming to play with that you really know how to use it. I would strongly recommend that you know how to cut and paste inside of a file, that you're able to indent or unindent lines because this is YAML. And if you're using Vim, make sure that you're really proficient at knowing whether or not you are in insert mode or command mode. And something that my Vim folks may need to be aware of is that if you paste in manifests from the documentation, suddenly all the indentation might go super whack. The way to fix that is with the set paste command. So make sure that you know how to use that in case things happen to go wacky inside of your exam environment. Using the wrong tool to troubleshoot. Especially in these later versions of the exams, troubleshooting is very much becoming a big, big focus of what it is that you're expected to do. And there are three that you should know how to use. Kube control describe is great because it allows you to look at the very bottom of that output in a section called events, and that will describe to you what's the status of the resource itself. Here's where you will find errors that are being caused on the Kubernetes side of things. Kube control get can list resources, but what you can also do is you can run kube control get events. This will list out all the events from all the resources inside of a namespace, the same things you saw at the bottom of kubectl describe. But now you can see them as a larger picture. So if you have objects that are kind of like of a piece failing together, then it might be easier to see how those are related. Then kubectl logs. Logs are looking at the standard error, standard output being created by your containers. So make sure you're using kubectl logs when you're trying to figure out what's busted about the container itself and not what Kubernetes is doing to screw things up. Writing manifests from scratch. Don't do this. They give you access to Kubernetes I/O on the exam for a good reason. Be very proficient at being able to search in the documentation exactly what types of objects you may need to make and how you can find those manifests inside. You are supposed to copy and paste those. But don't overlook the fact that a lot of manifests can be avoided being written in the first place if you know how to use certain kubectl create commands or other commands like kubectl run or kubectl expose. Not double checking your work. Look, if you're prepared for this exam, you should be able to finish it with a lot of time left over, depending on your approach. My advice, use 100% of the time that you are given. Go back, double, triple check every single task and make sure that you have completed everything that you were asked to do. C's get degrees. You don't get a special gold star for getting a 100% on these certifications. If you meet the passing criteria, you pass, full stop. What that means is don't be afraid to skip over tasks that you feel that you can't answer. You need to cultivate a test-taking mentality here, that we're just trying to get a passing score, and that's it. So even if that means skipping over certain tasks, which helpfully are weighted, some tasks are worth more than others. So if there's a task not worth a lot of points and you're not super sure how to tackle it, just skip it and come back to it if you have the time. And if you feel that you can only do part of the task, that is definitely better than doing none of the task. Partial credit can be a thing. And finally, not using Ulta 3 Academy to prepare for your exam. Look, it's a shameless plug, but if you want an easy to spin up browser environment, labs and videos that cover everything that are on both the CKA and the CKAD exam, as well as mock exams that will show you exactly how close you are to being ready to pass the exam, if you're not learning with tools like these, then you're doing it the hard way. So click the link down inside of the chat, try out our trial because we built these courses to help you to succeed. If you've got other tips, drop them down inside of the comments. See you next time, everybody. Best of luck on your exams.